At the end of this lesson, you will be able to define a source and learn how to add a source in Sumo Logic. Sources are configurations that collect logs and/or metrics from your hosts, appliances, and cloud infrastructure. Sources are added to collectors in a specific way, depending on the type of collector you're using. The maximum number of sources allowed on a collector is 1,000. There are a number of source types in Sumo Logic that work with installed collectors. Local and remote file sources collect logs from selected directories. Windows event log sources collect Windows events from the collector host or a remote one. Docker sources collect Docker container logs, events, and stats from Docker. Available for Linux, Mac OS, and Windows, host metric sources collect CPU, memory, and other OS metrics. Similarly, Sumo Logic can host many types of sources for you. Sumo Logic offers sources to collect from many AWS products. Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3, provides a web services interface that can be used to store and retrieve any amount of data to Sumo Logic. You can configure a cloud syslog source to allow a syslog client to send syslog data to Sumo Logic. Add a Google Apps audit source to ingest audit logs from Google Apps. You can export in real time all of the data collected by Stackdriver to Google Cloud PubSub. Sumo Logic uses the PubSub integration to push logs to our platform in real time. An HTTP source is an endpoint for receiving logs and metrics uploaded via a URL. You can even collect audit log content types to track and monitor usage of Microsoft Office 365. Once you've set up a collector on a machine in your environment, let's see how to add a source. In Sumo Logic, from the collection page, select a collector and click Add. From the drop-down list, click Add Source. For this demonstration, I want to look at the logs in the Apache Access file downloaded to my computer. That's a local file source, so I click Local File. Let's add a name to identify the source. For the file path, I am using the path to the Apache Access text file that I downloaded earlier. Let's enter a name for source host and source category so you can easily refer to the source in search queries. Remember, defining an appropriate source category will allow you to zero in on your data anytime by specifying the source category in your queries. Click Save. Click Collectors and Sources to return to the list on the collection page. The new source is now listed. The green check mark indicates that its status is active. Hover over the source category and click the blue search icon. The search page opens to show the search results. Sumo Logic will start ingesting data from the source. You can verify that your data is now being ingested by running a search. If you don't see any data, check the Apache Access file that you downloaded and make sure that the date stamp on the messages matches the time interval on the search page. We hope this video helps you to add a source using Sumo Logic. Thank you for joining.